Today we're sitting in my 2015 Subaru WRX Limited, and we're going to be talking about what type of oil is the best oil and what brand oil is the best oil for your Subaru WRX. I'm really sorry, guys, that was going to be more of a traditional vlog today, kind of camera in hand following me around, but I'm sure you can see out the window it is pouring down rain, and this is one of my few times during the week that I can film, so I thought I'd go ahead and make this video anyways because some people have been asking for it. So let's talk about oil. And before we get started, guys, if you haven't already subscribed to my channel and want to see more WRX or automotive content, please consider subscribing to the channel and hitting that little post notification bell. Let's talk about it. So first off, how often do you change your oil? How often do I change my oil? I typically change my oil with fully synthetic oil every 3,000 miles in my WRX. I've done that with every car that I own. I just feel that the car will run a little bit better if it has cleaner oil, and I think that kind of stands true. If you guys own WRXs, you'll know that these idle a little bit rough if you go a little bit too long without an oil change. I can't give you a solid reason there. I don't think there is any kind of factual evidence that dirty oil is actually making the car run a little bit rough, but I've always found when I change the oil, the rough idle goes away. So the past like 5 or so oil changes. I did an oil change when I first bought the car. I did an oil change after 1,000 miles after buying the car, and then kind of after 2,000 miles, so I could kind of get an idea of what was going on with the car and its oil, just because I didn't buy the car new. I wanted to know a little bit more about the car engine, and I wanted to know that it was getting clean oil through the engine and through everything, and I don't know. I'm a bit of a stickler for it, but I've run the same oil every time. And there's one big reason for that, and I'm gonna get to that in a second, but I'm using, this is not sponsored or anything, Valvoline, the 5W30, that's what you should be using for your WRX, that's what these engines are designed to take. Fully synthetic oil, and this is their Sin Power, or whatever you wanna call it. It is one of their premium, it says it's good for crazy amounts of miles. I don't believe it, I don't really care. This is the stuff that I use. I'm gonna go ahead and put this away, because it's in the way, and it's just an uncomfortable hole. Okay, so should you use that Valvoline 5W30? You should definitely use 5W30, but should you use Valvoline oil specifically? Now, is that the best oil for the Subaru WRXs? And the answer really is a quick one. Who really knows? Now, don't go and leave the video because I'm telling you the oil doesn't matter and, you know, there isn't like a best oil and a worst oil and it doesn't matter what type of oil and it's not gonna affect your engine, because that's not what I'm saying at all. From somebody that's building a community and kind of understands what a lot of people are looking for when they watch these videos or they wanna get out of these types of videos, there's an important consideration, especially as a content creator like myself, is if I go out and tell everyone to buy this Valvoline, right? This Valvoline might actually change over time. Hopefully my video gets that many views, I don't know. But as a content creator and somebody that's influencing buying decisions, it's important to have a variety on the market. Now, there have been plenty of tests, you know, testing oils, testing drip rates, but if you actually go and look at some of that information, it boils down to it's different every test, and it really is defined by the conditions of the experiment, and you just see different results, and, you know, batches of oil just aren't the same. They're slightly off. And there's tolerancing in the actual attributes of the oil itself. That being said, I think there's a couple important things here before I get to my point. If you're gonna go out and buy oil, I do recommend buying it from a name brand or something that you know people are putting in their WRXs, so you have a frame of reference. I, myself, try not to buy, like, off-brand or brands that I've never heard of before oil, and every once in a while you'll see something like that. I just stay away from it. To each their own. It could be good oil. I just go with high batch production oil. The next thing here, for everybody that's watching this video trying to find out what the best type of oil is for your car, the answer is pretty simple. It's 5W30, fully synthetic, and change it every 3,000 miles, 2,000 miles. My point being here is it's better to change your oil every 2,000 miles with, like, pretty good, probably really good oil than to try to buy the really best oil and change it every 6,000 miles. So let me tell you about why I chose Valvoline. I went on Amazon and this stuff was $22. And that was an incredible price because it's usually like 30 bucks in the store. So I bought a ton of these actually. I think I bought the limit of what I was allowed to buy at that sale price. But it's been, I've got more, obviously this is full, got more oil changes worth of this, and I've done a bunch already, so good stuff. The big message that I want to give everybody here is look for sales, get name brand big batch oil that's specifically designed for this car, that's 5W30, fully synthetic, and change it more often. If you're able to change your oil more often, it's just going to be healthier for your engine. I'm not saying change it every 1,000 miles, But don't wait to 5 to 7,000. Do it every 3,000. Do it every 5,000. If you're going to spend a little bit more money on oil, I'd rather you divert that money on more frequent oil changes with decent and good oil. Too many times do we see car owners look for the most expensive product or expensive thing so they can buy it once, have one purchase price, and then not have to worry about it throughout the lifetime of the car. And with oil, that's just not going to happen. It's going to be a recurring cost. So again, you want to balance big batch oil, meaning that popular brands, things that you know where people are putting in their car and that it's not blowing up engines. I don't think that ever happens, but that's a good thing. Feel free to do some research on what other people are saying, but most sources that you'll find, and from an engineering standpoint, there isn't a whole lot of difference between the premium oils. And then the next consideration is go with the little bit of a cheaper one, because you may be able to replace your oil more times with the savings that you're saving there. You guys know what I mean. Invest in more oil for a lower cost while maintaining still big kind of name brand oil. But you want to change your oil more often, then look for the most expensive, best option oil where there isn't a ton of science that says it's actually going to work for that. And just a quick disclaimer for all you guys who are like, there's better oils out there. Just because oil says it can last 100,000 or 300,000 miles doesn't mean it's going to last in a healthy way in your engine. And like Subaru says, I think they actually recommend that my oil is changed from 3,000 to 5,000 miles, which is pretty low, especially because it's fully synthetic. But whatever, you know, the testing has been done that that's the safest way to change your oil. And I just go with the lower bar on that, so I know that my engine, at least from an oil and lubrication standpoint, is as healthy as it can be.